Gentlemen, and welcome back to Wrath9 Gaming. I'm your host, Wrath, and let's go ahead and get into our first episode of a new modded survival playthrough of Fallout 4. Now, I've added a bunch of mods to this. Most of it is I've added a few weapons and a few quality of life mods. But a lot of it is more exploration and making it a more balanced experience. So I've got damage set so that damage taken and received is the same. It's really ramped up, so it's as dangerous for the enemy as it is for me. Stuff like that. So it's going to be a lot of excitement and fun. Now, I went ahead and prior to recording, I went and skipped through the... yes, we're going to continue to load. I went ahead and skipped through a lot of the initial part of the game so that you don't have to see the boring everybody does it, go through the start of the game and then get to Sanctuary and strip it down. I skipped through basically all of that just because that part of it is big time crunch and sort of a waste of time in terms of recording it, because everybody's seen it about a million times. So I went ahead and said, don't really need that. So we're gonna go ahead and get started. Now I've got the journey mod, and I've also got an exploration mod installed on this, so there's a lot of actual like new stuff that I haven't seen, and I don't know if it's actually because of those mods or if it's like stuff that was added since, because I haven't played this game in a really long time, like since before the DLCs. So, and I haven't played any of the DLCs yet, so that's all new content to me. But like, one of the things I ran into was when I first went through, and let's see here. Okay, so just a quick run through here. This is how I've got my perks set. I've got 3 for strength, 4 for perception. Hold on here. What do I have that's altering that? Okay, got 1 for strength, agility, and perception. So that's actually 3 and 4. I don't know what's actually adding to my endurance, but okay. And the bonus to agility. Wow, where am I getting all of the extra agility from? Well rested. Okay, 2 to endurance and 2 to agility. So that's what it's trying. So I've got 7 for my agility. Right now we're rocking the knife, a pistol, and a pipe pistol that we haven't modified yet. So we're kind of cruising along here. Now, one of the mods that I added was this sort of MacGyver mod that lets you dismantle guns into their various mods without having to, you know, basically like pay parts to just put it back to bare minimums. So we'll see if that is good. But like what I was saying is, see that trailer up there? I've never seen that before. I went into it and it had like some story elements into it that I've never seen or heard or anything. That got me really curious, and it sounded like some kind of mentally handicapped dude had been watching Kellogg when he raided the vault. So that was really weird for me, because I read it and I was like, what the heck? But we'll see. I killed a mole rat over here, but we're gonna go ahead and that was my phone being silly. Let's see what that was real quick, because that could be important. No, of course it wasn't. It was just bull crap. Because that's what they love to do. They love to feed you bullcrap. Okay, so I always come over here and get this stuff here, because this is like this little hidden spot that you can find stuff. And it's always worth coming over here because there's usually a few good things over here. And now I am being a little bit meta with this because you'll see that while I'm going through, before I go to Vault 81, because you only get one shot at the guy in Vault 81 without console commands. You only get one shot at the guy in Vault 81 to give him tools before he disappears into like a room that doesn't exist kind of thing, where like you can't get to and he never comes out of. So prior to going in there, I always stockpile the tools so that when I go in, I can get a boatload. You know, like I'll go in totally encumbered with tools so that I can just get a boatload of caps in one shot, because that's always very useful, at least from my mind. Now I'm not sure what to expect because with that weird thing being there, come on, yeah, thank you. With that weird thing being in what largely is a place that I'm used to seeing nothing. Oh, is there something there? Is that another new thing? Or is this just a rock? What is this? It's just a rock. I'm just being mental. Okay. Some more hub flowers. I know that there's some, there's some more hub flowers. I know that there's some thistle around here somewhere. And, like, I've totally gotten turned around. Yeah, I've totally gotten myself turned around. So one weird thing about going back here is that there is always a ton of just nothing back here, it would seem. Oh, there's the corn. So that way is the way I want to go, but let's grab the corn. Because we can turn that into... We can eat that if we need to, but... Otherwise we can sell it. Because unfortunately you can't turn the wild corn into like the plantable variety, which is kind of dumb, really, in my mind. Because, you know, why wouldn't you be able to turn the wild corn into seed corn of some kind to then, you know, be able to plant corn at your home? It doesn't make any sense. The same with the wild mute fruit. Why couldn't you seed that and be able to make more of the common variety by making seed stock out of it? Okay, now am I supposed to go this way? There's a little cottage back here somewhere that if you approach it correctly, like from behind, you can get the drop on the raider and dog that's in there, and it generally has a lot of good stuff, especially for early game. So we're gonna drink water. Now I have changed my my consumption rates so that I consume food a little bit slower than I do water, and water is still like slightly pared down from what the vanilla version is, but only minorly. So that is, yeah, okay, I think this is it. Let's get into stealth here. Let's see here. Yeah, see, there it is. There's gonna be a dog and a guy over there. And now because we have such high agility, we are gonna be super stealthy as it is. So we're gonna sneak up on this guy and we're gonna put bullets in his face. There he is. Let's go up and around. There's a trick where you can get in and ambush him. And we're gonna see what we got here. So we're gonna come around this side here, and this tree is exactly what we're looking for. Okay. And where is he? Where is he? Can you see us? Oh, there's the dog. Peek-a-boo! Oh, we just shot the dog. Oh, and baby's up. Oh, here comes the dog. Come on, doggy. Show me your face. Got no shot on you yet, but oh, here it comes. Here it comes. Hi there, puppy dog. This is my gun. There are many like it, but this one is mine. Alright, come on. Come on, show me your face. Booyah! Okay. We don't know where that guy is yet, and we don't want to take a shot from him. Let's reload. So this dude definitely does not understand the concept of fun. Not even slightly. I know you're here. Perfect. He's still inside, so as long as... Oh. Because what'll happen now is he'll go for a walk to look around the perimeter. And I will drop down into his little base here, and as he's coming back up, I'm gonna facepalm him. See, there he goes. We're gonna drop down, and we're gonna just gonna move you over there, please. We're gonna switch to our knife here. We're gonna wait for him. Oh, right there. That's what I'm talking about. You eat that. That's right. Alright, we're gonna take everything because we can. Dead body. That's a little weird. Okay. That's probably just one of the mods messing with physics or something. Okay, we got plenty of food. Now, there are some bloat flies, I think, over there, I want to say. But we're not going to bug them, because there's no reason to go after them. They're kind of worthless. Or rather, the risk to reward is not in our favor. Because three bloat flies can seriously screw us up, and... unfortunately, they just don't give you enough of anything to be worthwhile. Alright, same with these dogs. We're going to try to avoid them, but chances are we're not going to be able to get clear of them. That's new. Hold on. Hold on. That right there is new. Okay. We've got new stuff. Here, let's piss these dogs off. Let's switch to the pipe pistol. Come get some doggies. Come on, show me your face. Okay. Time to reload. Okay, where's the doggy that went this way? Oh. Okay, and oh, missed your head. Then pop it back up here. What the? Are you traveling into the ground? There we go. Okay. That's one. There's three of them. Saw one right down there. Okay, since they're down, we're gonna go ahead and go over here to what they were guarding, which is this chest here, which had a plastic knife in it. Oh, but you'll do. That works. Okay. Doggy's down. Alright. Raider, he's new. Double-barreled shotgun. That will work. There's a dead dog over here. And take your meat. Take the meat of these other two here. And toothbrush, because, you know, hygiene. Gotta have that. And baby girl talking. Baby girl talking. Alright, let's see here. Alright, there should be some armor or something over here. We'll take the blood leaf here. Blowfly meat, and yes, some raider armor and some leather armor. And those are always there because of spawns. So now we're gonna go and take a look. Now that guy that was there, let's see here, this house is new. So we need to be on our guard. Reload. Because I've never seen this before. And makeshift caverns with an expert lock. I can only do advanced at the moment, so this is definitely something to come back for. Discovery lone home. What is this? Oh, cheat! Combat knife, handwritten message. You're a monster. I'm taking and far too worn to read. It seems to suggest the note is unfinished. Three little bears. That's a cute reference. Ooh, cap stash. Handcuffs, military cap. Okay, so this place we're gonna need to come back to once we have more. Ooh, some cram there. We're gonna need to come back to this once we have more. That was Footlocker. Nice. Once we have a higher level of, let's take the car. Higher level of ability, then we'll come back here. See, is there anything in here? Nope. Anything around the front of this? Nope. Okay, so there's just that locked makeshift cavern. So let's, okay, where was that military cap? We'll put that on. How does that make us look? Okay, so we got a beret and army jacket on. Always good. Let's, just lock and load with this here. Oh, there's the guy that we're gonna shoot in the back of the head. So, gonna wanna try to be as sneaky as possible. Use this tree as cover so he can't see us. And just to be safe, we're going to quick save. Okay, use the tree to our advantage. I guess he's gonna come back. And then we're gonna blast him. No, he almost saw us. Actually, let's conserve some ammo here. There we go. Quick knifing, and he's down. As you can tell, our poor lone survivor here is actually pretty well maladjusted, in that he just does not get on with people very well. And we're over encumbered, and I turned off the damage while you're over encumbered because that's stupid. Just because I don't think that is a good mechanic to work with. You know, if they had like some scaling degree of encumbrance, then I wouldn't be so bad. But I don't think that, you know, it's, oh, as soon as you cross this tiny little line, suddenly you're carrying enough that it hurts you and slows you down. I think that once you get enough, you should be slowed down, but that's not enough to physically injure you. Not yet. So, it's, you know, I guess it's a potato-potato kind of thing. Alright, so we're gonna head back to our town. Now, if you don't know, all of the weapons and stuff that I've added in, I added in the 10mm submachine gun, the Garand, the service rifle, and the, whatchamacallit, the sniper rifle from earlier games. So they're all lore-friendly. They're all American weapons from the lore, so it's reasonable that they could be anywhere in the Fallout universe, anywhere that there was a military presence. So they're not lore-breaking, whereas, like, I don't really think that you should have, like, a lot of Chinese weapons, for instance, in Fallout 4, mostly because Fallout 4 was not on the Chinese front line. It was the farthest place from it. So, yes, they do have the whole thing with the sub, but the amount, the proliferation of those weapons in this space would be very, very uncommon. I'm like, that's new. So that house up there and that are both new additions. And I don't know if they're part of the new of the Explorers mod that I put on, or if they were stuff that was added since the last time I played. But either way, they're a welcome addition, because they definitely make things more interesting. Now I do also have the Beacons mod that lets me what is the phrase that I'm looking for? It allows me to... What is that over there? Wait a minute. There's something there. What is that? I can't see it clearly. Are my eyeballs not working right? Or is this a trap? It's a rock. Okay. Staring at rocks and seeing things. Yay. I'm a retard. And I don't mean that I'm mentally handicapped. I mean that I'm stupid and have decision-making challenges. Because, let's be clear. If you have a disability, you're not retarded. But if you make clearly bad decisions. Yes, I know, I'm digging myself into a hole, honey. But it's a hole worth digging. Ooh, lots of booze bottles. Whoever owned this little shanty, this little fishing thingamadoo, did a lot of their drinking here. Not that I can blame them. It's the end of the world. Watch it with a smile on your face and some alcohol in your veins. That sounds like a great idea. We'll take the teddy bear. More. And some tar berries. And a raider body. Hey. I'm liking this more and more. If this is just added by the adventure mod, five M1 carbine. Oh, nice! Take everything else you've got. Now I'm feeling kind of saucy, because that gives us a whole bunch of stuff to work with now. Yeah, we gotta crawl along here, but that's the nature of the beast. Oh wait, I already raided the boat over here, so I don't actually need to go over here, but I'm tempted to see what else is around here, because that raider's new. So what else is new? Because that's awesome. M1. I wonder what kind of ammo it uses, because I don't actually know what the... I think the M1 used 308. I think. And I'm really hoping, because I haven't, like, checked out anything about the particular weapons in the game, so I'm really hoping that it's actually, like, spectacular, but not, like, OP. Because I definitely want it to be usable, but not, like, overpowered. You get my meaning? I want it to be on par. Let's take a look at it while we got a chance here. Glow-sided. Okay, so there's a pipe pistol. We're gonna swap you out for our other one, since you've already got some stuff going for you. And look, a short M1 carbine. So we've got 11 rounds. What do you use? You use 5mm. Okay. Not sure that I agree with that, but I'll accept it. Some graves. This feels nice. I don't want to waste any shots with it though, just to feel how well the animation with it is. So, ugh. That feels so nice. Although if I remember, the minigun uses 5mm, so yeah, this might actually, picking up the minigun might actually give me a plethora of ammo for this, as long as I remember to save the, not use the minigun and just use this. What's the damage on this thing? 37. That's not bad. It's a good hefty rifle. It's probably equivalent to like a bolt, one of the bolt actions. Okay, so we're a little parched and we're a little hungry. So it's time to sit back and drop off all of this junk that we've gotten now and begin our exploration. So we've got we've already talked to Cosworth. He's already told us go to Concord. So we'll do all of that now. Let's first dump all of that. Alright, so dump the extra combat knife, dump all of these, dump the knuckles. Let's dump that, we don't need it. Okay, don't need the cage armor. Oh, although it would be nice, I don't want it. Harness, rags. Okay, let's see. Don't want. Alright, we'll go with the leathers for now. Let's see here. Don't need that. Don't. Pompadour wig might be useful. That's charisma. Road leathers. Side hood. I'll take those. And then longshoreman. Okay. Bloodfine meat. Blood pack. All of those. That. All of those. Keep that. Iguana bits. Iguana on a stick. Medix. Drop that. Alright. We'll keep the cup of noodles, the cherry, the Nuka cherry we'll keep just in case. We got plenty of all the other stuff. Anything else? Let's see here. So, don't need the fusion cells. Shotgun shells we can keep. 10 mil. Don't need the 45. So we'll drop that. Okay, that leaves us pretty good. We're gonna pare down our ammo though. So I think we're not gonna need all that much. Let's bring this down to. We want, again, another 60. Let's see here, 50, 48. Gotta try and travel a little bit light. Alright, so let's get a little bit of food and a little bit of water. Since we're going to be drinking one of those anyway. Alright. Quick roast of some nut chops. Okay, and let's get all of our bottles, because I think that dropped all of our bottles in here. So, junk. Da-da-da-da-da-da. Bottle. Anything that says bottle. Beer bottles. Bottle. Bottle. Bottle, milk bottles. Any of the bottles in here? Liquor bottle, Nuka-Cola bottles. Rum bottle. Vodka bottle, whiskey bottles, wine bottle, lots of empty bottles. So let's go fill those bad boys up. Alright. Nothing like a little purified water to make your day feel good. This might take a while. So anyway, I've also got a mod on here for that allows you to craft like backpacks for both yourself and dog meat. So I will be using those. Because, you know, that would be awesome. Dun 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 dun. All right, so we got to decide what to do for our next perk, because we got the level of it, and part of me wants to avoid getting any of the perks that require you to basically pick a default weapon type. I wanna have some freedom there. So I think what I'm gonna do is, since I've been kind of building this guy as a sneaky killer, we're gonna go with ninja, because that's an all-around get the drop on somebody and you get to blast them before they know what's going on. So we'll definitely pick that up. I think third level we're gonna pick up Gun Nut though. We're gonna have to. Ugh, how long is this gonna take? Really? A dooble. Pumping away. So I actually lucked out, because I always like to wear the military, the army uniform. But I actually lucked out, because I actually got it. It was here in Sanctuary, and I didn't have to go looking for one, which is really nice. It makes it a lot easier to get around, and that extra strength and agility is very, very useful to start off with for a character that wants to be sort of a... It's good for a melee character, especially if you've got agility, like an agility strength build. A character that sneaks up and then kills with melee. Let's see here. Turn all those on. So we're going to go ahead and... Oops. Bring up our thing here, and we're going to go ahead and select ninja for personal killing, for all your personal killing needs. Okay, so we've got that. Let's go ahead and eat and do our drink. Let's see here. Mutt chops. So we're properly fed, properly hydrated, and we'll go ahead and dump all but five of these. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Alright, that gives us plenty of water. We've got some cup of noodles in case we need them. Now it is time. Let's not use that. Let's use our pipe pistol here, our upgraded pipe pistol that we found. And let's press on here. So, I should have taken some grenades with me, because I do like having this character have, since this character has military background, I like having this character usually have some kind of, let's see here, okay. I'll take whatever you've got. And let's check the bag up here. 45 and a pipe revolver pistol. Alright, let's explore this way. Because I know what's the other directions. But I also know that there's a radstag over here, and we're gonna drop him. Because that radstag is good eats for us. Okay. And there should be a dog over here somewhere. There's the dog. Dead meat. Oh, an angry baby. An angry baby has shown up. Okay. We need to assign this guy to one of our quick slots here. Let's put him on 4. Okay. Get in as close as we can. And headshot. Ooh, that hits really hard, and that feels nice too. A loud bang, and you're dead. Okay, we'll put that away. Switch to our pipe pistol. Since we currently have the most ammunition for that, that will be... Oh, jeez. That tire scared the bejeezers out of me. It's like... I don't know what it is, just with seeing the new content makes me suddenly, like, super nervous in this game. Alright, that's up there, so that's as far as we're going to go this way in one shot here. We'll hit this and then circle back to the red rocket. So we will switch that up, because we know that up here is a nice 44 that we can use, although when it comes to high damage, I think this rifle is going to be our go-to facepalmer, because it's pretty damn powerful. Okay, so take the 44, the pistol, take the cans, bobby pins, postman uniform. Oh, we're detected. Take all of these medical supplies here. Where are you? Come on, you gnarly little buggers. Show me your face. It's kind of like, feels like a scene from Tremors. If you don't know what that is, I'm just showing my age. It's an old sci-fi horror movie. Sort of, it's almost on Mystery Science Theater 3000 level. For how sort of comical it is. I think once we get to the Red Rocket, we're gonna pull our resources. I think we're actually gonna stop the recording there and call that an episode. So where did these little buggers go? They're here. I know they're here. They're just hanging out in the ground. Let's reload. Okay. I know that they're here. Where's that one that I shot? He's here. Oh, crap. You eat that one. Oh, angry baby. Angry baby. So angry. So baby. Oh. None can compare to the angry of angry baby. You know what? Did we ever actually pick up the... Did we pick up the deer meat? Suddenly wondering if I picked up the red stag meat. Oh yes, I did. Okay. Not feeling quite as stupid. Although there's plenty of room for that. As my wife would say, and will say probably momentarily, just digging myself a hole. Okay. Supplies. There's this little spot right here. Stuff, ammo. All right, and so here we are picking up our lovely friend Dogameat, and even the baby has quieted down because she sees a puppy. Nope, never mind. It's not her puppy. She's not happy. Oh, baby girl, not happy. Hello, doggy.
What are you doing out here all by yourself?
Alright, let's go.
Okay.
Good doggy.
Let's stick together.
Reload this bad boy. And medical supplies. And there's a storm coming in. Now I've got the one of the weather mods installed that's got some really freaky weather. Oh, dust storm. Let's get inside. Alright, close this door here. Wish you could shut these, like, shutters or something. Okay. Melon. Military grade duct tape. Take that. Take those definitely. Okay. More. Ouch.
Hey.
See if he had anything worth. Grab anything useful.
Okay. Let's get inside here. That storm is brutal. Let's see what we can find here. Okay, let's see here. Alright, we're encumbered again. Did you close that? Okay, and okay. We'll go ahead and try to put together some supplies here real quick. Out of all this junk here. Some metal, scrap everything. So we're just, first of all, going for anything and everything that we can use. All the parts on the inside here. Okay, lots of rubber here. One of the things you always got to be mindful of this that I've found is you got to be mindful of the order at which you scrap everything, because it does not give you, like, if you forget to scrap something that's on top of something else and it's not something that's going to transfer over or remain, it does not give you like a credit for those items. I don't care about that. Scrap that. Okay. That should give us, oop, storm's passed. This should give us enough to work with to do upgrades to our guns and get moving. So I don't want to spend too much time here. Ooh. Getting lots of metal. Ah, lamppost. Full of stuff. Always good. Alright, I think we can skip most of the other stuff here. Let's clean up right outside the door here, since it's our space. Yeah, I keep saying, oh, it's just going to be real quick, and it's not, because I'm, like, totally, like, a nut with this stuff. Okay. Good enough. Alright. Let's see what upgrades we can do to our weapons. Alright, we got to start with the carbine. Okay, so receiver requires a lot. So we're gonna be hanging on to this thing for quite a while. Okay, short barrel, short light barrel. Okay, short light barrel it is. Stock, short stock or full stock? No. 15 round. Okay, so we're gonna be working with that for a while. Sights. Okay, so this is definitely meant as a long-term weapon. So it's going to be an alternate sniper rifle for us here. Not really worried about those. Let's see what upgrades we can do. Light frame. Missing oil and screws. We could probably do that back at our other base. So let's do that. Let's end the episode here. I'm gonna run back. Oops. I'm gonna run back to Sanctuary real quick to do some quick modding of the weapons, and then we will pick up back here again. Until next time, I hope you've enjoyed. Please leave a like, subscribe, leave comments. Let me know how I'm doing and how much you're enjoying this. Until next time, I will catch you on the flip side.